Hello, survivors. How's your stay in Erangel's prison? Today is the last day of our tour, so if you have any remaining questions about the island, be sure to let us know as we move. Yesterday we saw Rozak, the mansion, the prison, and even the Hall of Fame. Today we're going to start at the famous Milta power plant, pass through Pochinki, check out the old quarry, and wrap up our journey on the island of Sosnovka. Pile into the UAZ and let's get moving. Milta was one of the first nuclear power plants in this area of the world, and enabled Erangel to sustain its civilian and military populations. Some historians even speculate that the quarry up the road was used to mine some of the materials that went into building Milta, giving the people of the island plenty of work to do. We know from evidence found around the island that Milta was targeted by the resistance. By the looks of things, they succeeded. The damage wasn't enough to cause any kind of nuclear incident or anything like that, but I'm sure they had a purpose. Another of Erangel's major cities is Pochinki. And if you haven't picked up on the general theme of the island by now, it's also surrounded by farmland. Close to the heart of the island, it's pretty easy to imagine why Pochinki would be fought over. And fought over it was. In fact, curfew posters and red flags still hang all over the city, which served as a strong hint that it's better to just obey. Not everyone just rolled over on command, though. If you thought Pochinki was a hot drop in the battlegrounds, just take a look at all the craters, tanks, and general destruction left in the wake of what went down here. You've no doubt noticed all of the resistance signage around the island. In fact, I'm sure the military wondered how they were getting so many of them past their inspections. Well, the truth was found here in this hideaway warehouse. They printed them right here on the island. This warehouse was more than just a print house, though. Operations were planned, communications were relayed, and it probably served as an easy-to-get-to hideout for those keeping an eye on Sosnovka. Now, the quarry here was a key commercial venture for the island. Stone from here can be found in architecture all across the land. The stone even matches up with some found in the ruins to the north, meaning this site has been in use long before modern Erangel existed here. Even newer structures like Milta Power Plant have stone and brick that seems to have originated here, which suggests that the military either contracted or more likely just forced the workers here to supply their demand. That forced labor could have been a reason for the resistance to target this site for liberation. Nowadays, most of Erangel's visitors make it to the island by plane and parachute, but back in the day, it was more likely you'd take a ferry from the mainland. While most of the island's supplies were offloaded up north in Georgiapol, this is where the majority of the people came and went. That wasn't this little town's only trade, though. Abandoned fishing boats still line the beach here, and this area and Primorsk were likely home to many of the laborers who worked at the quarry. It also appears to have been home to a pretty large battle between the resistance and the military, as the craters and husks of aquatic vehicles line the beach to the west. Now, I know you've all been seeing those dead vehicles laying around and wanting to get inside one, so we've got another treat for you. If you wouldn't mind hopping into our authentic Battlegrounds Tour Agency, BRDM2, we're gonna ride the waves over to Sosnovka Island. Remember that when you're telling your friends and family about how great of a time you had here. The island of Sosnovka was a key factor in Erangel's painful history. Connected to the island by only its two bridges, Sosnovka is where the military established their base from which they'd carry out their plans and overall occupation of Erangel. Now onto the location everyone's been waiting for. Sosnovka Military Base. You know it as one of the bloodiest places on the battlegrounds, but during the Erangel conflict, it was one of the safest places for the military to be. Heavily fortified with soldiers, artillery, and red propaganda, this base easily helped establish the military's hold on Erangel. That's not to say that the resistance never made their way in here. There's strong evidence that points towards one of the military's own guided missiles as the cause for the destruction over at Milta Power Plant. Infiltrating this base couldn't have been an easy task. What historians find most odd is that not even the military base was spared from the bombardment in 65. Maybe they thought it easier to wipe everything out instead of recovering it or losing it to the black market. Might even been some other reason it got leveled, but we may never know for sure. And that's a wrap. Now, you all may not be getting the same type of chicken dinner an actual battleground survivor would get, but we do have a catered chicken dinner waiting for you back at the hotel. And remember, your package includes a discount to any of our other battlegrounds tours. So be sure to take advantage of that and get on the waiting list today. We hope you enjoyed your experience with the Battlegrounds Tour Agency, the world's most authentic way to experience the battlegrounds like never before.